are new developments in the death of George Floyd, the unarmed black man in Minneapolis who died in police custody.
Yes, world, it happens again. A black man killed by a white cop in the USA. Dave Chappelle, what's your thought about it?
And for some reason that I still don't understand, all these fucking police had their hands in their pockets. Who are you talking to? What are you signifying that you can kneel on a man's neck for 8 minutes and 46 seconds and feel like you wouldn't get the wrath of God? That's what is happening right now. It's not for a single cop. It's for all of it. Fucking all of it. I don't mean to get heavy, but we gotta say something.
Hey, hey. Pop the trunk, yeah. Open up. I sold my soul a good price, yeah. Out of sight. My hoe got talent, right? Yeah. Whole squad ran, do that shit.
Because over the weekend, Black Lives Matter rallies continued spreading around the globe.
Black Lives Matter and anti-racism protests continue around the world. Thousands in Europe, Asia, and the South Pacific continued marching to call for equality.
Black Lives Matter still reverberating around the world. Massive protests in Japan, New Zealand, South Korea. This is the U.S. Embassy there.
Welcome back to Mad Life, where I share some slices of my life. His name was George Floyd. As a black man, I try to see or to listen to my environment and to try to see if anything has happened. And this is what I found. Exactly, I found nothing. As a black person and speaking with some other black people in big corporations, I think we keep our mouths shut for two reasons. The first one is that we are afraid that if we speak up, we may be fired. And the second reason is that even if we are not fired, we might be blacklisted if we want to progress in this kind of organization.
When you go for a job and you go for an interview, you talk pretty on the phone to the guy. Then when you come through the door and he sort of sees your face, seeing that you're black, he's trying to hide his shot. But underneath, such and such, and then you're gone. You got no chance. Job centres and all that, they all try, you know what I mean? But it's nothing really. Don't get now. Lucky ones. Say like you have to be better than them to get the same privileges as them.
As a black person, I'm affected by three things today. First thing is white privilege in society. The second thing is systemic racism towards black people. And talking about solution, what can black people do to overcome this situation? I thought about it a lot and tried to write a lot of things, and finally I thought that I will let people talk about it better than me. So let's hear them out.
And they would explain that, no, you can't be racist to white people. You can be prejudiced towards white people. Prejudice is just kind of prejudging someone based on whatever factor. But in order for something to be racism, there has to be a systemic inequality, a systemic power imbalance, which is added to the prejudice. And so in most societies, you can't be racist towards white people. You can be prejudiced, but you know, this power dynamic is not there to subjugate white people. Whereas a white person being racist to a black person, that is prejudice plus a power dynamic, and therefore that makes it racism.
So that what you have here in Hume, which is interesting at least because it is the area in which Engels did much of his work for the book The Conditions of the English Working Classes. This is precisely the same area. It's interesting because the black people have now become the new underclass that structures British society by being maintained at the bottom. So what they meant was, by integrating black people at the very bottom of society with the worst families who had the major kinds of problems and so on and had fallen to the bottom of white society. This, in fact, satisfied the city and they felt that their policy was successful. They advertised it widely throughout Europe as an answer to the problem of black people. There are two entrances only, and this means that in a situation of social control, if, for instance, one of the famous British black riots develop or whatever, because they make these things when they decide to, it is perfectly feasible and easy to control these buildings because there are only two points of access. And a relatively small force of army or police can control all these all the people within these buildings.
Look, this clearly isn't about individual officers. It's about a structure built on systemic racism that this country created intentionally and now needs to dismantle intentionally and replace with one that takes into account the needs of the people that it actually serves. And this is going to take sustained pressure and attention over a long period of time from all of us. Black communities have had to be perpetual activists while also routinely being disenfranchised. And it is long past time that the rest of us join to make sure that their voices are heard and acted upon.
Equality has nothing to do with whites. We don't want to be equal with the white man. He's not the criteria or yardstick by which equality is measured. He's not in a position to tell us we are equal. It's not his right. It's not his to do. Equality, we want equality. We had equality before the white man was created. We had equality before the white man came into existence. And we want equality whether the white man is on this earth or not. Equality means the opportunity to develop all of our dormant potential, all of our dormant capability. In developing this dormant capability, the right and the ability to stand on this earth on some land of our own and bring about a civilization and a society in which we will be completely independent.
It is a terrible thing for an entire people to surrender to the notion that 1/9 of its population is beneath them. And until that moment, until the moment comes when we, the American people, are able to accept the fact that I have to accept, for example, that my ancestors are both white and black, that on that continent we are trying to forge a new identity for which we need each other, and that I am not a ward of America, I am not an object of missionary charity, I am one of the people who built the country. Until this moment, there is scarcely any hope for the American dream, because the people who are denied participation in it, by their very presence, will wreck it. And if that happens, it's a very grave moment for the West.
The only reason people want to hear from people like me is because you trust me. You don't expect me to be perfect, but I don't lie to you. I'm just a guy, and I don't lie to you. And every institution that we trust lies to us.
He was black. His name was George Floyd. Anything else to add, Trevor?
Now here it is, your moment of Zen.
To you.